Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our Easter sunrise service here at St. Andrew's Calgary. God has the power to roll away stones. God is good. God is great. God is with us on this day of joy. Those of you with eagle eyes will notice that this is not the H for Heritage Park, which is where we'd originally hoped to meet this morning. But we are here together in the sanctuary of St. Andrew's, celebrating with you this most holy day in our year of faith. Welcome one and all on this wonderful day. Almighty God, you wonderfully created, yet more wonderfully restored the dignity of human nature. Grant that we may share the divine life of the one who shared our humanity, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
O day of resurrection, let us shine with joy.
Christ has led us from death to life.
O day of resurrection, let us live with hope.
Christ has led us from earth to heaven.
Christ has risen from the dead.
He has risen indeed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. This day and always.
One. the prayer of adoration and confession. God of life and love, maker of all things visible and invisible, on the first day of creation you spoke, and out of chaos came life. Out of darkness came light. On the first day of the week you raised Christ from the tomb, and out of death came new life. On the first day of this week, you call us to gather in Christ's name, to rejoice in the power of resurrection, and claim your gift of new life in the Spirit. Blessing and honor and glory and power be unto you, O God, Creator, Christ, and Holy Spirit, this day and always. Trusting in the power of God to make all things new, let us confess our sins before God and one another.
Almighty God, you raised Jesus from the grave and shattered the power of sin and death. But we confess that we remain captive to fear and bound to habits that hold us back from enjoying new life in Christ. Indifference deadens our hearts, and we seek comfort rather than justice. We cling to hurt, resentment, and disappointment, and refuse the freedom that comes with forgiveness. Forgive us, O God, and restore us to the joy and new possibility promised to us in Christ, our risen Lord. Amen.
Hear the good news. Who is in a position to condemn us? Only Christ. And Christ died for us. Christ rose for us. Christ reigns in power for us. Christ prays for us. Friends, believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven and set free by God's generous grace.
Morning has broken. Blackbird has spoken,
Spirit of power and new possibility, through the scriptures, open our minds to understanding, our hearts to loving, and our wills to carrying out the mission of the risen Christ, God's living word. Amen.
A scripture reading from Psalm 118, verses 1 to 2 and 24. Oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His steadfast love endures forever. Let Israel say, his steadfast love endures forever. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it.
Now a reading from Mark 16, verses 1 to 8. When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome bought spices so they could embalm him. Very early on Sunday morning, as the sun rose, they went to the tomb. They worried out loud to each other, "Who will roll back the stone from the tomb for us?" Then they looked up, saw that it had been rolled back. It was a huge stone, and walked right in. They saw a young man sitting on the right side, dressed all in white. They were completely taken aback, astonished. He said, "Don't be afraid. I know you're looking for Jesus the Nazarene, the one they nailed on the cross. He's been raised up. He's here no longer. You can see for yourselves that the place is empty. Now, on your way, tell his disciples and Peter that he's going on ahead of you to Galilee. You'll see him there, exactly as he said." They got out as fast as they could, beside themselves, their heads swimming. Stunned, they said nothing to anyone. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Who will roll back the stone from the tomb for us? This is the question that we face in our lives when we have doors that appear to be locked before us, stones that are immovable, something that cannot be crossed over. And the answer for us, as it was for those surprised disciples, is that Jesus rolls away the tomb and makes locked doors open for us in our own lives. In Mark's gospel, this is the sometimes termed the hurry-up gospel because of the way it's written. There's so much that is rushed in it, and we are left with the impression that disciples are beside themselves, their heads swimming, stunned. They said nothing to anyone. But gradually, the truth and the power of the insight that they'd reached by visiting the empty tomb came over them, and they were allowed and invited to put faith into their lives. What I love about this passage is the, it's not scolding so much, but it's a sense of encouragement and admonishment that they receive. The place is empty. Now, on your way. And so this message is for us as it is for anyone. It was a message for them of that time. It is a message for us. Now, on your way. This is the message of Easter Sunday, that we are called to put faith into our own lives. And when we do this, we will find that there is no stone that can be put in front of our way. Our faith allows us greater power, the power to create, to roll away those stones, to transform lives, to work for justice, to confront racism, and to strive for bringing Jesus' power into our own lives. This is our invitation. This is our celebration. This is our credo. This is our claim. May God be with us all on this Easter Sunday. Amen.
Let us pray. God of new life, break into situations of illness, pain, grief, and loss with resurrecting power. Where there is sickness of body, mind, or spirit, bring healing and hope. where people mourn the loss of relationships or dreams. Bring comfort and courage to go on. Where those who serve and care and maintain our common life are exhausted, bring rest and renewal. Resurrect, renew, and revive your people, O God.
Hear our prayer.
God of Easter Day, break into moments of celebration and joy. Give us gratitude, the impulse to share, and a spirit of grace and understanding. Resurrect, renew, and revive our spirits.
Hear our prayer.
God of new creation, break into the circumstances, places, and lives that we name in the silence of our hearts. Resurrect, renew, and revive your people.
Hear our prayer.
Now we pray in one voice the words that Jesus gave.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Because I grow, he holds the future.
in peace to love and serve the risen Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thanks be to God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.